Have you ever taken a survey that asks you to check all that apply? Some people may check one response, or none, or all of the responses. Now, that may be an interesting way to ask a question, but it can be a nightmare if you do not know how to handle that kind of data in IBM SPSS statistics software. We are going to dive deeper into how to handle multiple response items in SPSS. When you use a survey item that asks respondents to check all that apply, you will use the multiple response option in IBM SPSS statistics to analyze that item. Sometimes researchers ask questions in which the respondent may choose one item from a list, or multiple items, or none of the items. If I ask you what type of pets you own, you may have dogs but no cats, you may have fish but no birds, you may have a single bird, you may have a fish tank plus a few dogs, or you may have none of these pets. Multiple response items are often combined with a single item that asks people for their most important response, and then presents them with the same list and asks them to check all of the responses that apply for them. I am going to show you how to cross-tabulate a multiple response item with another item to drill down into the data to discover more meaningful findings. For this example, we will use the CleanRiverMulti.sav dataset. This is fictitious data about how people use a river. And I designed these data to illustrate this multiple response example, hence the word multi in the title. We will use three questions. Why are our local waters most important to you? We're looking for only one response here. Followed by, which of these are important to you? Check all that apply, giving people the opportunity for multiple responses. And finally, I would like to receive more information about the Passagassawakeag Watershed Alliance. Yes or no? This will be the item that we will use later for cross-tabulation. The Passagassawakeag is a river in Maine, USA. And the Passagassawakeag Watershed Alliance is a fictitious organization dedicated to protecting the watershed into the river. They raise money each year at the Passagassawakeag Bean Boil and Music Festival. Years ago, I was roommates with a former Passagassawakeag Cabbage Contest eating winner. But I digress. First, let's get a look at our data. In variable view, we can see that people were asked if this factor was important, and the responses are coded as 1 equals yes, 0 equals no. Remember that 1 is the value that will count. The most import variable lists all of the possible responses, and the send info variable is also coded as 1 equals yes, 0 equals no. Let's examine the item about the most important reason. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies. We just need a simple frequency table. Move the variable most import into the variables box, along with the send info variable, and click OK. We see that 32.5% of people asked to receive more information about the alliance. We can see how many people selected each of these options as the single most important feature. But we have lost all of the information about the second and third and fourth most important features. Some of the lesser important factors may still be important, however. Well, now that we have a clearer picture of our data, we will create a variable set. Go to Analyze, Multiple Response, Define Variable Set. Here, we will tell SPSS which items need to be combined for our multiple response set. We will move all of these variables from the Check All That Apply item into the variables in set box. The variables are dichotomies, yes or no, with a counted value of 1, because 1 equals yes. If they answer no, that was coded as a 0, and it will not be counted toward our accumulated values. So what is this categories option? We would use the categories option if we had an ordinal set of response options that we wanted to count a range of the responses as a single type of response. So perhaps we have a Likert scale question that was coded such that the three highest scores represent some level of agreement. We want to compare the respondents who answered with some level of agreement to those who were neutral or disagreed. Using our dichotomous variable, we will name our new multiple response set something simple, important. We could even create a label, something like the original question, which of these are important to you? When you're done, click Add. Now that we have created the set, click Close. Now at this point, we might expect to see the output window pop up, but nothing really happens, and that is because all that we have done so far is to define our variable set. So next, we need to tell SPSS what to do with it. We are going to cross-tabulate these data with our question about whether a person wants to receive information about the organization. We want to know if people who feel that a certain factor is more important are more interested in receiving information about the organization. Go to Analyze, Multiple Response, Crosstabs. We will move our new multiple response set, which we called Important, into the Rows box. In the Columns box, we want to place our item about interest in receiving information about the organization. Before we can analyze, we need to address these question marks. Remember that our data were coded as 1 and 0. Click on Define Ranges. For a minimum, type 0. And for maximum, type 1. Now click on Options. Get the cell percentages for the rows, then click Continue and OK. Over 32.5% of people asked to receive more information about the alliance. What we see here is that people who indicated that any of these factors were important were more likely to ask for information about the organization. You can cross-tabulate a multiple response set with any nominal or ordinal variable in your data set, or even with another multiple response set.